So dear students, this is our second class on time value of money. So first we'll do a quick recap of what we studied in the first class. So in the first class, I told you why do we pay interest. So there were three factors. One was risk factor, then we had opportunity cost, then we had the most important thing, value of money decreases over time. Then we moved on to our next topic, which was simple interest. So what was the formula for simple interest? It was PRT by 100. As I told you, R is expressed in percentage, and if we do R by 100, then it becomes in decimal. So what is the formula for amount? What is amount? Principal along with some interest accumulates to something in the future. So what is that future value? That is amount. So principal plus the interest. Again, next, we did compound interest, in which we get interest on interest. Like in simple interest, interest is received or paid only on the principal amount. But in compound interest, we get interest on interest. So there is compounding of interest, okay? So what was the formula for compound interest which we studied? Amount is equal to principal 1 plus R by 100 whole to the power T. So this is the formula for compound interest. Again, we did accumulation factor. What is accumulation factor? Accumulation factor is how many times my fund has grown. So we also learned about the relationship AF is equal to 1 by PVF. What is this? There is an inverse relationship between accumulation factor and present value factor. Now, how to calculate accumulation factor? Let us take a very small example. Again, let's say suppose that interest rate is 10% and the sum of money is standing at time zero. Let us take the amount to be rupees 100. So rupees 100 is there at time zero. If we want to take that rupees 100 from 0 to 1, we need to multiply by an accumulation factor. So what is the accumulation factor? Accumulation factor will be 1.1. So for year 1, like for 1 year, the compounding factor or the accumulation factor is 1.1. If we need to take rupees 100 at the end of year 5, so we need to compound it for 5 years, then what will be the factor? In this case, the factor will be 1.1 to the power 5. So what is the accumulation factor for 5 years? It is 1.1 to the power 5. If we want to take this rupees 100 to time 4, at the end of year 4, then what will be the accumulation factor? It will be 1.1 to the power 4. It will be 1.1 to the power 4. So this we learned. Again, we learned pulling a sum of money which is there in the future, pulling it down to the present, pulling it back to the present. So how to do that? Let's say suppose a sum of rupees 200 is there at the end of year 5. A sum of rupees 200 is standing at the end of year 5. We need to bring this rupees 200 to time 0. So how to do it? We'll do, and the interest rate is 10%. Like sometimes when we need to pull the sum of money down to the present, down to time 0 or something in present, it can be time 1 also. Like from year 5, if we pull it to year 1 end, then it is also known as discounting. Okay? In this case, we are discounting it for 4 years. And in this case, we are discounting it for 5 years. And if we bring it to year 2 end, then we are discounting it for 3 years. Okay? So, this is discounting. Now, what I was trying to say is, a sum of money is there at the end of year 5. If we need to bring it to time 0, then we need to do 200 by 1.1 to the power 5. This method is known as discounting. This method is known as discounting. So they may use interest rate / discount rate simultaneously. they may use either interest rate or discount rate. So you do need not worry that we studied interest rate, but here it is discount rate. So it's all the same, okay? The process is same, everything is same. So this content we did cover in the first class. And one more thing, whenever we take a sum of money in the future, we multiply it by the factor. And if we want to pull it down to the present, we'll divide it by the same factor to nullify the effect. This is a very important thing. Okay? So now, I will teach you the concept compounding multiple times in a year. It is not so that compounding is always in per annum terms. What do you mean by per annum terms? Like, let's say suppose 100 is invested at the rate 6% per annum. This is not always the case. 6% per annum. We can get a case in which the compounding is being done every quarter. We can get a case in the exam in which the compounding is being done in a month, in every half year. So we need to deal with those kinds of sums also. Okay. So let's say suppose 100 is invested at the rate 6% per annum and the compounding is being done every half year. The compounding is being done every half year. So how to deal with this? If 6% is the rate for 1 year, then what is the rate for a half year? We need to first think about that. So, I'm asking you all a question. How many half years in 1 year? The answer is 2. So how many times compounding is being done in a year? 2 times. Okay? So if 6% is the rate of 1 year, what is the rate of a half year? We need to think about that. What is the rate of a half year? It is 6 divided by 2, which is 3% per half year. So 3% is the rate for every half year. So in 1 year, there will be 2 times compounding. And what is the rate? It is 3%. Okay, now let me teach you. This is 0, this is 0.5, and this is 1. What is 0.5? Half year. Okay. So if we need to take the money from 0 to 0.5, we need to multiply it by a factor. So what is the factor? You need to think about that. Now the factor is not 1.06, because compounding is not being done every year. Compounding is being done multiple times in a year. Okay. Compounding in this case is being done 2 times in a year. So if we need to take the money from 0 to 0.5, we need to multiply it by 1.03. Because the effective interest rate for every half year is not 6%, it is 3%. 6% is the rate for every year and 3% is the rate for every half year. So if we need to take the money half year forward, we need to multiply it by a factor 1.03. And again, if we need to take the money from 0.5 to 1, then we need to again multiply this by 1.03. So what is the conclusion? Now, if we are investing 100 rupees and we need to take forward the money from 0 to 100, we need to accumulate the money from 0 to 1, then we need to do 100 into 1.03 square. You can copy this. I repeat, if we need to accumulate the money from 0 to 0.5, we need to multiply it by a factor. And what is that factor? It is 1.03. How many half years in a year? 2 times. So the compounding is being done 2 times in a year. And what is the factor of every half year? It is 3%. It is 3%. What is the factor? The factor is 1.03. The rate is 3%. Sorry, the rate is 3%, and the factor is 1.03. So if we need to accumulate a certain sum of money 2.5 years forward, then what will be the factor for 2.5 years? It is 1.03 square. Let us take one more example. 6% per annum compounded quarterly. 6% per annum compounded quarterly. So first, this is the rate for per annum. We need to find the rate for a quarter. So we need to divide this by 4, because in 1 year there are 4 quarters. What is a quarter? A quarter includes 3 months. So the rate comes to 1.5% per quarter. So the rate includes, sorry, the rate is 1.5% per quarter. So let's say suppose we invest 1,000 rupees and we need to accumulate this 1,000 rupees for one quarter. Then what will be the factor? Now the factor will be 1.015 for one quarter. If we need to accumulate 1,000 for two quarters, the factor will be 1.015 square. If we need to accumulate 1,000 for four quarters, the factor will be 1.015 to the power 4. And then we'll get the answer. Okay? But just a small clarity that I want to give you all is, this is 6% per annum compounded quarterly. So the effective rate per quarter is 1.5%. So the effective rate per quarter is 1.5%. Okay. Now we'll do a question, which you can get in my worksheet also. I'm reading the question out. Shubha invested 10,000 at an interest of 12% for 3 years. So let me write down a few things. Rupees 10,000 at the rate 12% per annum, 3 years, for 3 years. Interest is compounded quarterly. So if the interest is compounded, we can write here, compounded quarterly, right? Compounded quarterly. So 10,000 at the rate 12% per annum compounded quarterly. So 12% is per annum rate. So what is the effective rate for one quarter? We need to divide it by 4, because in 1 year there are 4 quarters. So in this question, this means, just hold on for a second. So in this question, this means that the compounding is being done 4 times in a year. That comes to our topic, compounding multiple times in a year. Okay? So 12 by 4, it comes to 3%. So 12 by 4, it comes to 3% per quarter. It comes to 3% per quarter. So if in 1 year there are 4 quarters, then how many quarters in 3 years? It comes to 12 quarters. It comes to 12 quarters. So if we need to accumulate 10,000 for one quarter, then what is the factor? Like, I'm talking from the first class about that factor thing. So what is that factor? The factor will be 1.03 if we need to take forward 10,000 for one quarter. Okay? Now let me draw a timeline. Now here I am denoting the quarters. So if we need to take the money from 0 to the first quarter end, then we need to multiply it by 1.03. This is the factor. This is the thing which I need to teach you. There is no formula for this. They have given a very difficult formula, but I don't want to teach you anything with any kind of formula. We will not use any kind of formula. Okay? So it's 1.03. So if we need to accumulate 10,000 for 4 quarters, then what will be the factor? 1.03 power 4. And if we need to accumulate 10,000 for 12 quarters, then what will be the factor? 1.03 to the power 12. Then what will be the factor? 1.03 to the power 12. Is it clear, everyone? So here we go with the question. So it's 10,000 into 1.03 to the power 12. Okay, so it's 10,000 into 1.03 to the power 12. And now you are given a question. You are given FVIF, which is future value interest factor. You are given 3,12. So this is not 3,12, this is 3%,12. This is 3%,12. So the future value interest factor, this will be given to you in most of the questions, but still you need to understand, right, what is the mechanism that is going on behind this. Okay, you need to understand the purpose of studying this, because this is something which you'll use in your real life when you go to big corporates. So the future value investment factor that is given in the question is 1.4262. Okay, so we need to just simply multiply, because this is, if we do it manually and if we go by formula, then it's 10,000 into FVIF, which is 10,000 into FVIF, 3%,12. Now we can just write 1.4262. So the answer comes to 14,262 rupees. So this is the answer. So the answer is 14,262 rupees. So is it clear, everyone? Now, I've never discussed something like this. Future value interest factor. So it is nothing. It is nothing. It is just like we are accumulating rupee 1. Like in this diagram, I can explain you. We are just accumulating rupee 1 from 0 to the end of 12th quarter. We are taking a sum of rupee 1 from 0 to the end of 12th quarter. So this is future value interest factor. And then again there is PVIF. Okay, not now. We'll just do a question and then we can do this. Okay. So have you done this question? You can just copy this question. So this is question number 1 of my assignment. You all can get it in the link of this video, the PDF of this assignment. So this is question 1. So now the next question. Question 2. So question 2 I'm reading. NADA is offered either to receive 5,000 one year from now or 7,000 5 years from now. Okay, let me draw a timeline. $5,000 one year from now or 7,000 5 years from now. Which one NABA will accept and which one NABA will accept and why if the discount rate is 10%? I told you, like whenever they will talk something about pulling back some of money which is there in the future, they will give you the word discount rate. And whenever they talk about accumulating a sum of money from present to the future, they will give you the word interest rate. So don't confuse. Okay, given present value of rupee 1 at 10% R, so they have given you PVIF. So what is this PVIF? It is present value interest factor. So present value interest factor, 10%,1 they have given you, and present value interest factor, 10%,5 they have given you. So what is this? 0.909 and 0.621. So this they have given you. So let me explain you all what is this. Let me take a very separate timeline. So if there is rupee 1 at the end of year 1, then what will be the present value of this 1 rupee at time 0? So we are discounting for 1 year. So we are discounting for 1 year. So what will be the present value factor at the rate 10% for 1 year? I have explained this in the previous class also. We can do this manually also. Let me show you. It is 1 by 1.1. Okay? And if we need to discount rupee 1 for 5 years at the rate 10%, so what will be the present value factor? It will be 1 by 1.1 to the power 5. So it's very simple. We can do it manually also, but in most of the questions, you need not worry. They will give you this thing. They will give you this thing. So you need not worry about anything. Okay? So you can try it out at your home. And like you just check, the answer will come same. So this we know. And we need to decide now which one will Nada accept and why. So let's do it. Solution. We will calculate the present value of both the cash flows. We will calculate the present value of both the cash flows. So what is the first cash flow? The first cash flow is 5,000 1 year from now. So 5,000 into present value interest factor 10% comma 1. Like they have given in a sentence, but that sentence can be represented by this expression. So you should know, because they can give this expression also in the examination. So present value interest factor 10% comma 1. So this is 5,000 into 0.909. So this comes to 4545. Again, present value of 7,000. 7,000 into present value interest factor 10% comma 5. So this comes to 7,000 into 0.621. Now this comes to 4347. So Nada will accept, because this is a Nada cannot accept both. So you don't think that Nada will be accepting both of it, because Nada has been given a choice that either you can take 5,000 at the end of year 1 or you can take 7,000 at the end of year 5. So Nada will accept the cash flow. I'm writing it down. Nada will accept the cash flow which has higher present value. So Nada will accept the cash flow which has higher present value. So you can see which cash flow has higher present value. Cash flow 1. So Nada will accept cash flow 1, which is 5,000. So Nada is going to accept cash flow 1, which is 5,000. So this was our second question. Okay? Now we'll do one more question. Question number 3. It is again a sum on multiple times compounding in a year. Okay? A sum of 5,000 is invested for 2 years at 10% interest rate compounded biannually. So what is this biannually? So what is this biannually? Biannually means compounding 2 times in a year. Biannually means compounding 2 times in a year. So 5,000 is invested for 2 years at the rate 10% per annum compounded biannually. So what is the rate of per half year? Because biannually means we're dividing a year into two parts. Okay, compounding is being done 2 times in a year, and 10% is the rate for 1 year. So what will be the rate of every half year? So it will be 10 by 2, which is 5% per half year. Okay, so we need to now, we need to calculate the maturity amount. So maturity amount is given by 5,000 into 1.05 to the power 4. Because we need to accumulate rupees 5,000 for 2 years. So in 1 year, there are 2 half years. So in 2 years, there are 4 half years. So 5,000 into 1.05 to the power 4. So this comes to 6077.50. So this comes to 6077.50. If we need to express this in future value interest factor, then what will be the expression? Let's just try it out. FVIF, you know, there are two kinds of things. We'll study it further. One is annuity factor and one is interest factor. Interest factor is for a single payment, and annuity factor is for a stream of payments. Like, let's say suppose 5,000, 5,000, 5,000, 5,000, 5,000. So this is an annuity. What is an annuity? Annuity is a regular series of payment. And now we are using interest factor. So interest factor is for one payment, and annuity factor is for a stream of payments that we'll study in the coming class, or maybe today only later. So future value interest factor, 5%, 4. So this is nothing but the accumulation factor at the rate 5% for 4 half years. So this is, if you can calculate, this is 1.05 to the power 4. If we need to accumulate 5,000 for 1 half year, then the interest rate, the interest rate is 5% and the factor will be 1.05. If we need to accumulate 5,000 for 2 half years, the factor will be 1.05 square. If we need to accumulate 5,000 for 4 half years or 2 years, the factor will be 1.05 to the power 4. So future value interest factor 5%, 4 is 1.05 to the power 4, which is 1.2155. Which is 1.2155. So this is how we approach when compounding is being done multiple times in a year. So I hope so this topic is clear to you all. You can just copy it down. This was question number 3 from my assignment. Okay, now we'll do a very basic question, which is question 4 of my assignment. A very basic question. This is just a recap of the first class. So, a trader deposited 4 lakh in a bank at the rate 8% per annum compound interest for 5 years. So, 4 lakh at the rate 8% for 5 years. How much will he get at the end of 5 years? And we have been given the compounded value of rupee 1 for 5 years. Now, please, I'm going to write in the expression because we need to learn that. So this is nothing but it is FVIF, future value interest factor, 8%, 5. It is 1.469. Future value interest factor, 8%, 5, which is 1.469. So, now we need to calculate how much will he get at the end of 5 years. So, 4 lakh. Now what is 4 lakh? 4 lakh is the present value. 4 lakh is the present value into FVIF 8%, 5. Now please wait. If I write it like this, can I write it like this? Like what is the factor? I'm going to write it with some different color so that you make out the difference. What is the factor for 1 year? If we need to accumulate 4 lakh for 1 year at the end of year 1, if we need to take 4 lakh from time 0 to time 1, then what will be the factor? It will be 1.08. If we need to accumulate 4 lakh from time 0 to time 5, from year 5 end, like from time 0 to year 5 end, then what will be the factor? It will be 1.08 to the power 5. So we can also write it like this. 4 lakh into 1.08 to the power 5. So this comes to 5,87,600. 5,87,600. So you all can copy this question. Now we'll move on to the next question. So which is question number 5. Amal wants to invest 5,000 for 4 years. He invests the amount at 12%. He invests the amount at 12% per annum compound interest. Interest accruing at the end of each quarter. So this is nothing but it is 12% per annum compounded quarterly, correct? So we need to calculate the effective rate for 1 quarter. So the effective rate for 1 quarter is 12 by 4, which is 3% per quarter, which is 3% per quarter. And he invests 5,000 for 4 years. What amount will he receive after 4 years? So it's very simple. In 1 year, there are four quarters. In 4 years, there will be 16 quarters. So if I just draw a timeline, this is 0, this is 16. So we need to accumulate this 5,000. So we need to accumulate this 5,000 from time 0 to the end of 16th quarter. To the end of 16th quarter or 4th year. I have divided year into number of quarters because the rate is given in terms of quarters. We need to calculate the effective rate. That is the main point which I'm trying to explain. We need to calculate the effective rate per quarter. Okay? We are dividing a year into four parts. So this is 12 by 4, which is 3% per quarter. So now the amount is 5,000 and the rate is 3%. So can we say if we need to accumulate a certain sum of money for 1 quarter, then what will be the factor? It will be 1.03, like 1 plus I. And what is I? 3% for every quarter. If we need to accumulate 5,000 for 4 quarters, then what will be the money? Then what will be the factor? It will be 1.03 to the power of 4. But here we need to accumulate it for 16 quarters. So what will be the factor? It will be 1.03 to the power 16. So this is nothing but it is FVIF 3% comma 16. We are accumulating rupee 1. Like if we only talk about this future value interest factor, we are accumulating rupee 1 at the rate 3% for 16 time periods. Because this future value interest factor doesn't know that it is for a quarter or it is for a year or it is for half year. This knows as one time period. And what is the rate of interest per time period? It is 3%. Effective rate. We always work in effective rate. After this, I'm going to explain you a very crucial part of this chapter. Okay? So this is 1.6047, which you can calculate also. This may be given in the question or may not be given in the question, but you can calculate. I have told you how to calculate. You can calculate this from the calculator. So 5,000 into 1.6047, so this comes to 8024 approx. Now, the main thing which I'm going to talk is this will not be tested in the exam, but it is very important for you all to know because whenever you go to a bank, you may get confused or you may get fooled because of exotic banking products. So this is what we need to learn. Like 3% per quarter and 12% per annum are not the same. Are not the same. Like if I say 3% per quarter, here the compounding is being done. Like we have done this sum. Now we are not related to the sum. I'm taking just this small example to explain you all a very important concept. Like let's say suppose this is case one in which the compounding is being done 3% every quarter. And this is case two in which the compounding is being done 12% per annum. Okay. So here it is, if I say the heading compounding, in this the compounding is being done every quarter. Every quarter, and the effective rate for every quarter is 3%. And here the compounding is being done annually. Here the compounding is being done yearly. And the effective rate per year, like if I talk about the effective rate, per quarter in this case is 3%. per quarter. And here it is 12% per annum. So number of times compounding is being done per year in case 1 is 4 times. But in case 2, number of times compounding is being done per year. In case 2, it's 1 time. Are you getting it? Are you getting it? So, I just want to express this, that 3% per quarter effective and 12% per annum effective are not the same. Because in this, if we need the accumulation factor for 1 year, in second case, it is very simple. It is 1.12. Because compounding is being done every year, so it's 1.12. But in this case, we need to accumulate it for 4 quarters. So what is the factor for 1 year? So what is the factor for 1 year or 4 quarters? So let's start. So what is the accumulation factor for 1 quarter? It is 1.03. So what is the accumulation factor for 2 quarters? It is 1.03 square. So what is the accumulation factor for 3 quarters? It is 1.03 cube. And what is the accumulation factor for 1 year or 4 quarters? It is 1.03 to the power 4. And if you just calculate, please just let me know what is the answer. Just calculate this one. To 1.1255. And here it is 1.12. So from now onwards, you can just understand this point that 3% per quarter effective. Like it's very simple. If someone says that you're getting interest at the rate 3% per quarter effective, okay, and the compounding is being done 4 times in a year, and there is one other person, then there is one more person who is getting 12% per annum. So you think I'm getting 3% per quarter and he's getting 12% per annum. So it's all the same. No. The person who is getting 3% per quarter is getting more. Or if he's paying 3% per quarter interest, he's paying more interest than the person who is paying 12% per annum. It is a very, very, very important concept. So here, the interest rate or the factor for 1 year is 1.1255. But here, the factor is 1.12. So if I just talk, what is the effective rate of interest? What is the effective rate of interest for 1 year if the effective rate of interest every quarter is 3%? It is 12.55%. So this is the thing which you all should know. What is the effective rate of interest per year if the effective rate of interest, I'm just asking you all a question. What is the effective rate of interest per year if the effective rate of interest per quarter is 3%? So the answer is 12.55%. So from now onwards, if someone says you 1% per month effective versus 12% per annum effective, so which one is more? It is 1% per month, dear students. Because 1% per month, what is the accumulation factor for 1 month? It will be 1.01. What will be the accumulation factor for 1 year or 12 months? It will be 1.01 to the power 12. So it's not 1.12. It's not 1.12. It's much, much more than 1.12. Okay. So this is the thing. So we can say that 3% per quarter is approximately 12% per annum, but it is not exactly 12% per annum. The whole motive of giving this in the question like they give, like in all the questions you will see, they give 12% per annum compounded quarterly. So the whole purpose of giving this, they want us to calculate from this line the effective interest rate for every quarter. If they say 12% per annum compounded monthly, so the whole and sole purpose of giving this statement is they want us to calculate the effective rate for 1 month. But 12%, as per this statement, 12% is not the effective rate for 1 year. No, no. If I talk for this, the effective rate for 1 year in this will be 1.03 to the power 4. So this is the accumulation factor. So this should be equal to 1 plus I. So from here we need to calculate the I, which we did here. So it is 12.55%. So it is 0.1255 or 12.55%. So in this case, again, we need to do 1.01 to the power 12. Now we need to equate this by 1 plus I. From here we need to calculate the I. So it will come to very close to 12.68%, or if we express this in decimals, it's 0.1268. So this is a very important concept in time value of money, which we all should know. This is not related to your examination, but if you go to a bank, this is something which we should know. This is something which is very important. Okay, now let me ask you a few questions. So if say it's 18% per annum, and I'm asking you, compounded yearly. So what is the effective rate per year? It is 18%. Compounded monthly. So what is the effective rate per month? It's 18 by 12. It's 1.5% per month. So what is the, if it's compounded quarterly, so what is the effective rate per quarter? It is 18 by 4. So it comes to around 4.5% per quarter. Okay. If it's compounded half yearly, so what is the effective rate every half year? It is 18 by 2, which is 9% per half year. So these things are very important. You can copy this. If it's compounded, let's say suppose 2 monthly, if it's compounded 2 monthly. So 2 monthly is a bit tough. Wait. 2 monthly. So in a year, if we go by 2 months, there are 6 2-months. Correct? Like if you go by 2 monthly, then we are dividing a year into 6 parts. So it's 18 by 6. Okay. So it comes to 3% per 2 months. Correct. So this is something which we need to know. It's a very important concept in finance. Whether you're doing anything, if you're studying this, then you should study it with whole heart, because it's a very, very, very important concept. Okay. So I hope so. I've made myself clear. Okay. So let's once see this again with a very small example, and then we'll end today's class. Now let's say suppose there are 2 banks, one is SBI and one is HSBC. So SBI gives 6% per annum compounded yearly, and HSBC gives 6% per annum, which is compounded half yearly. So let's just draw the tree diagram. Suppose I invest 100 in both the banks. 100 here. So for the SBI bank, it's going to be simple. It's 100 and it's 6. So the amount which I'm going to get is 106 after 1 year. But in HSBC bank, it's compounded every half yearly. So what is the effective rate? So what is the effective rate for every half year? It's 6 by 2. So it's 3%. पर हाफ ईयर, सो इट्स 3% पर हाफ ईयर, सो 100 सो 100 सो फॉर द फर्स्ट हाफ ईयर इट्स गोइंग टू बी 103 बिकॉज इट्स 3% इंटरेस्ट पर हाफ ईयर, सो फॉर द फर्स्ट हाफ ईयर इट्स गोइंग टू बी 103 इंटरेस्ट. फॉर द नेक्स्ट हाफ ईयर, सिंस वी ऑलवेज टॉक अबाउट कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट, ओके, सो वेन एवर दे वॉन्ट टू टेल यू दैट यू नीड टू डू द सम बाय सिंपल इंटरेस्ट, दे विल मैंशन द वर्ड सिंपल, एंड इफ नथिंग इज मैंशन यू नीड टू अज्यूम कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट एंड यू नीड टू डू द सम. इट्स वेरी सिंपल. वेन एवर द वर्ड सिंपल इंटरेस्ट इज मैंशन, यू डू बाय सिंपल इंटरेस्ट, एंड वेन एवर नथिंग इज मैंशन और कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट इज मैंशन, देन विल डू बाय कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट. सो फॉर द नेक्स्ट हाफ ईयर इज गोइंग टू बी अगेन 103, बट दिस 3 विल ऑल्सो गिव अस इंटरेस्ट, सो इट्स 3 एंड 3 इंटू 0.03, सो दिस कम्स टू 106.09. जस्ट होल्ड ऑन, जस्ट चेक वंस इट्स करेक्ट. 3 इंटू 0.03, या. सो नाउ लेट अस कंपेयर बोथ दी बैंक. सो विच बैंक शुड आई डिपॉजिट मनी? इट इज HSBC बैंक. ओके, सो डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज्ड. सो हियर इफ आई से वॉट इज द एनुअल इफेक्टिव रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट, सो इन बैंक वन द एनुअल इफेक्टिव रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज 6%, एंड इन बैंक टू द एनुअल इफेक्टिव रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज 6.09%. सो नाउ आई हैव मेड माई सेल्फ क्लियर. नाउ वॉट इज, सो इट्स 3% पर हाफ ईयर इफेक्टिव एंड इट्स 6.09% पर ईयर इफेक्टिव, बट आई कैन ऑल्सो से दैट 3% पर हाफ ईयर इफेक्टिव इज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 6% पर एनम, बट नॉट एक्यूरेटली 6% पर एनम. इट इज 6.09% पर एनम इफेक्टिव एंड एक्यूरेट. अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 6%, एक्यूरेटली इट इज 6.09% पर एनम. सो आई होप सो दिस वीडियो विल हेल्प यू ऑल इन योर स्टडीज. ओके, थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो.